Now, Channel 3 Early Warning Weather with meteorologist Mark Dixon.
There have been some on and off showers or sprinkles over the course of the past several hours, and that's still the case here in the noon hour. We're zoomed in with early warning pinpoint Doppler. Basically, along up and down Route 8 from Harwinton through Plymouth, Waterbury through Oxford and Seymour and Shelton and Sonia. Looking at, again, just a few sprinkles as they're lifting to the northeast. So basically what we see here is what we can expect for the next couple of hours. Otherwise, at times more clouds than sun, but certainly some intervals of sunshine and temperatures across the state. Still in the upper 50s in the Northwest Hills, but 60 to 65 elsewhere inland, mid and upper 60s right now along the shoreline. We're going to top out this afternoon between 65 and 70. If we get more clearing, maybe a degree or two above 70 in a few spots with more sunshine. So the winds are up out of the south at around 5 to 15 miles an hour, bringing in a warm air mass, also some higher dew point values now, well into the mid-50s in many locations. So that is something that's going to continue throughout the day tomorrow. That southerly flow is going to get stronger. It's going to get breezy. Tomorrow, wind gusts say over 20 miles an hour for our Wednesday, and that's in advance of a cold front that eventually will move through, bringing a slight chance for some showers later tomorrow and then some cooler weather for the latter half of the week. So our iCam view from Torrington showing the clouds and some patches of blue, a similar scene coming in from Hartford. You can see the dark bases of those clouds looking like they could produce a little shower activity, and they very well could in a few spots, but it's going to be brief, again, very spotty in nature. There's our view from New Haven as well, and also from Southeast Connecticut checking in on New London. So throughout southern New England, we've got the cloud cover building, those spotty showers that really have just been confined to Connecticut and Massachusetts, now working a bit into New Hampshire. So not any sort of meaningful rain, unfortunately, because that is something we need with those deficits that we still have and the drought conditions across the state. So as we look at future casts, those little splotchy areas of green will be exiting as we head toward the evening commute time with clearing taking place. So again, with that sunshine, temperatures go up a little bit higher from where we currently stand. And then tomorrow we'll have that southerly flow. So overnight tonight, like today, some patchy fog around to start our Wednesday. And then tomorrow afternoon, as a cold front approaches from the northwest, there's the chance for a spotty shower, maybe an isolated thunderstorm. Any sort of severe weather threat is to the north of the Mass Pike as we head through tomorrow afternoon and evening. There you can see the coverage kind of shrinking on these showers as they work their way through southern New England, say between 4 and 8 p.m. tomorrow. And then behind this cold front, the wind switches to the west and northwest. It's going to be rather gusty on Thursday, sending cooler air into the state. We're also monitoring Hurricane Delta, our 25th named storm of the hurricane season, and it has been rapidly intensifying. Winds now up to 130 miles an hour. That puts it as a Category 4. Jump from 2 to a 4, right over a Category 3 since the update this morning. And as it heads toward the Yucatan Peninsula, the tip of it arriving early tomorrow morning. And then even as it works through the central Gulf of Mexico, major hurricane Cat 3, Cat 4, by Friday morning, 7 o'clock central time, on the approach to Louisiana, and then inland by Saturday morning. So as conditions deteriorate on Friday, interest from Louisiana eastward on the lookout for this storm, as it's going to pack quite a punch as it works inland. So that will be another landfalling U.S. Tropical system, a hurricane, before the week is over. Here in Connecticut, 75 tomorrow, a little bit cooler behind that cold front and windy. Wind gusts say over 30 miles an hour on Thursday, perhaps as high as 40 miles an hour. Not as windy, mostly sunny, low 60s on Friday after starting the day in the 30s. So that's when we could get some frost in those usual colder spots. And the weekend features a big warm up back into the mid 70s, dry weather Saturday, Sunday. Columbus Day, some of that remnant moisture from Delta may get drawn northward. So there's that chance for maybe a late day shower on Monday for Columbus Day. Otherwise, for shoreline highs this weekend, low 70s for Saturday and Sunday.